Good morning, students. So in the last class we discussed on a variation method. So we used a variation principle and we could calculate the energy eigenvalues and the wave function. We guessed the wave function. In variation method we guessed the wave function and we were able to calculate the energy values. And this value will be very close to the experimental value, true value. So that will be our actual energy value. So this is what we calculated. And we have applications of variation method. We have mainly three applications for your syllabus. One is ground state energy of hydrogen atom, and another one is ground state energy of helium atom. Then the last one will be simple harmonic oscillator. Okay, so we are going to get the energies and eigen functions. Okay, for these three using variation method. So applications to hydrogen atom first. So now we are going to guess this trail wave function. Okay, we are for the hydrogen atom. This is spherical symmetry. We are going to guess this trail wave function. Whether this guessed trail wave function is correct or not, according to the answer that we are going to obtain, it depends on. So your sin naught of r for the ground state, which is equal to a e power minus alpha by a naught. Okay, where alpha is the variation parameter, and your a naught will be Bohr radius. Radius of the first Bohr orbit. So here we are talking about ground state energy. So angular momentum is equal to zero. First we will calculate the normalization constant. For all the problems we will have to calculate only with the first starting point will be calculating normalization constant. So normalization constant is given by 0 to infinity psi star of psi d tau, which is equal to 1. So you have psi of r is given by this. So psi star of r is given by the same factor because there is no I content here. So same thing. So this can be multiplied by the same eigen function. So that will give you e power minus alpha by a naught whole square. Okay. Then of course, as we said, this is about hydrogen atom. So we'll have to use only radial part, angular parts. Correct? Spherical harmonics. So spherical harmonics for hydrogen atom, that will give you 4 pi. So this is your radial part. So the contribution from the spherical harmonics, that will be 4 pi. So 4 pi multiplied by radial part. So 4 pi r squared dr. So you pull a squared out, normalization constant a squared out, and this can be written as e power minus 2 alpha r by a naught 4 pi r squared dr, which is equal to 1. We are going to get the value for a. This is for normalization constant. Okay, now we'll keep this factor 2 alpha r by a naught as x. So r will be a naught divided by 2 alpha x. So just to square this term, because we have to have the square term, so square this term, that will give you this, and differentiate with differentiate, so that will give you dr equals a naught by 2 alpha dx. You substitute the required terms, so you have a squared e power minus x, this is termed as x, so e power minus x 4 pi, your r squared will be this one, and you have dr will be a naught by 2 alpha dx. Is it okay? Now pull constants out. A squared will be there, 4 pi, your a naught squared is there, correct? So you have another a naught is there, so a naught cube. Similarly 2 alpha squared is there, you have another 2 alpha, so 2 alpha cube. So a naught by 2 alpha whole cube, and remaining term will be e power minus x squared dx, which is equal to 1. And what is this one? 0 to infinity. And this will be your gamma integral, gamma 3. Gamma 3 equals 2 factorial. Gamma n equals n minus 1 factorial. So gamma 3 will be 2 factorial. Simplifying, that will give you a squared equal to this term. Okay. So 4 pi multiplied by 2, that will give you 8 pi. Okay. So you have 1 divided by 8 pi, 2 alpha by a naught to the power 3. And your a will be, taking the square root on both sides, a will be this one. Okay, now we can simplify these two terms as alpha cube. This is pi to the power 1 by 2. Okay, I can pull it inside. So pi to the power 1 by 2. So this can be written as alpha cube a naught cube. So a cube alpha naught cube pi to the power 1 by 2. So we have obtained the normalization constant a first. You substitute in the wave function. So we will get the complete wave function. So like this. Now we'll have to calculate using variation principle, we are going to calculate now E naught. Okay, and of course it is given by this principle, variation principle, and we are going to get this expression first. Just take the numerator. Just take the numerator. So your Hamiltonian sandwiched between normal wave function and complex conjugate. So that will give you this term. Now instead of which you can substitute kinetic energy and potential energy term. So you have kinetic energy and potential energy term. Is it okay? Now this kinetic energy term we can term as del squared, can be written as exactly like this: 1 by r square d by dr, r square d by dr. You just differentiate. This can be written as, you just keep this as constant, you will differentiate this, plus keep this as constant, you will differentiate it, you will have this one, this term. So multiplied by 1 by r squared, you bring that term inside, that will give you d squared by dr squared, correct? D squared by dr squared plus 2 pi r d by dr. So instead of this radial part, you can write this. So I have written exactly like this. So your del squared is replaced by this one. Is it okay? Your del squared is replaced by this term. Okay, multiplied by wave function. This is your wave function. First we have taken only kinetic energy part, correct? So we have taken only kinetic energy part, not the potential energy. Only we have taken only this term alone. Okay, so this is your kinetic energy part sandwiched between normal wave function and complex conjugate. So now you have to differentiate this. So differentiate with respect to r square, two times you have to differentiate this and get the answer. You have to differentiate only once this wave function and get the answer. You substitute, you will get alpha squared e squared by 2 a naught. We have taken this as in terms of atomic unit. One atomic unit is nothing but 27.2 electron volt. Here we are going to consider this as h bar squared equals 1 and e squared equals 1 and m equals 1. So keeping all those things, we can convert this into another unit, which is nothing but atomic unit, in which these terms can be considered as exactly as equal to 1. Because h, when you take the h value, this will be 6.634626 in 10 power minus 34 js, squaring 10 power minus 68 js, and when you take e square, e will be 1.6 10 power minus 19, squaring that will give you 10 power minus 38, it's very tedious. M also 9.1 10 power minus 31 kgs. So for that we have just go with the some other unit, so which we call this atomic. So this is in terms of atomic unit. So your kinetic energy, which is equal to given by this expression. Okay, now potential energy, the second term, this is the potential energy. So potential energy is minus e squared by r sandwiched between your normal wave function and its complex conjugate, correct? Minus e squared, complex conjugate. Again do the same thing. So that will be your assignment. You will get exactly the answer for potential energy will be minus alpha e squared by a naught. So total energy equals kinetic energy plus potential energy. So add this one and this one, you will get this. So this will be your total energy. The variation principle says that we will have to minimize the wave function. Variation principle, that is the main idea. You have to minimize the variation with respect to variation parameter. What is the variation parameter here? This is only the variation parameter. Alpha is the variation parameter and your a naught will be Bohr radius. Okay, so alpha is the variation parameter. So you are going to minimize with respect to alpha. Okay, so now you have to differentiate this with respect to alpha. It means when you are going to differentiate, this will be 2 alpha, this will be 1. So you will get 2 alpha e squared by 2 alpha, 2 to get cancelled. You have this expression, this will be e squared by a naught. You pull e squared by a naught out, so that will give you e squared by a naught alpha minus 1 equal to 0, so alpha becomes 1. So we have found out the value alpha. You substitute in this expression, that's minimum. Okay, that is the idea of variation method. Okay, so you'll have e squared, so this one we have found out now alpha value. You substitute in this expression, so your alpha will be 1. So e squared by 2 a naught minus e squared by 2 a naught, so this will give you minus e squared by 2 a naught. Right, 1 by 2 minus 1, which will be minus 1 by 2, half minus 1. So that will be minus 1 by 2. So minus e squared by 2a naught. So the value is the energy eigenvalue of the hydrogen atom in terms of atomic unit. One atomic unit is nothing but 27.2 electron volt. So your E minimum is this one. And your wave function is this one. So we have calculated, we have assumed the wave function. Okay, we have assumed the wave function, we have obtained this one. And this wave function, the obtained value is exactly equivalent to the value that we are going to obtain for the hydrogen atom. Okay, so we can say that the using variation method, we have found out the ground state energy eigenvalue and the wave function. So this is the idea. Okay, stop.